In the part 1 of this video, we saw how 24-volt industrial devices are interfaced with the Nano to build an industrial PLC. This video will improve on the motor starter with the addition of an overload relay to the contactor. The LRO2D13 thermal overload relay is connected directly to the contactor with these 3 pins. It has a normally open and a normally closed contact that provides status feedback to the controller. This red button is for testing the trip feedback status. The overload relay is either set to auto or manual reset after a trip by this blue button. I will leave it as it is for auto reset. The trip current is adjustable between 5.5 to 8 amps with this regulator for this overload relay. A trip indication of bright yellow appears here when this is an actual trip, which can be tested by pressing down this button with a small screwdriver. Now, let's build the Arduino PLC on a thin rail. First, mount 5 pieces each of red and black terminal blocks on the DIN rail for 24-volt power distribution to the PLC components. Screw both sides of the Arduino Nano terminal adapter board to these 35mm DIN rail mounting adapters and mount it on the DIN rail. Also, screw 2 optocoupler and a relay module to the DIN rail mounting adapters and mount them on the DIN rail. I used a Vero board to screw the modules to the mounting adapters due to the screw hole mismatch. I also made a 24-volt to 12-volt step-down power supply module to provide power to V-in of the Arduino Nano with an LM7812 voltage regulator. You can buy a ready-made one with the link in the description. Finally, I have mounted these 3 switches for start, stop, and alarm reset, these 3 indicators for motor running, stopped, and trip indication, and a buzzer indicator for 4th alarm on this makeshift board. The 3 switches are connected to the PC817 module and then to D2, D3 and D4 of the Nano as was done in the part 1 of this video. In the same way, connect NO auxiliary contact of the contactor to N4 of the isolator module and V4 to D5 of the Nano. Also, connect the NC contact of the overload relay to N1 of another PC817 module and the V1 to D6 of the Nano. Then connect the 3 indicators to D7, D8 and D9 as was done in the part 1 of this video. Finally, connect D10 and D11 of the Nano to N1 and N2 of the relay module with the buzzer indicator and the contactor coil. One terminal of the buzzer indicator is connected to 24-volt positive and the other terminal to NO contact of the first relay. The common terminal of the relay is then connected to GND. This contactor is rated at 220-volt AC. Thus, 220-volt AC lifeline is connected to the common of the other relay, while its NO contact is connected to terminal A1 of the contactor coil. Terminal A2 is then connected to 220-volt AC neutral line. Ensure that the AC main supply is turned off before carrying out these connections. To ensure proper operation of the Arduino PLC before inserting the Nano to its adapter, turn on the AC main to the power supply module. Press the three switches, the blue section of the contactor, and the overload relay trip button, and ensure the respective LED in the optocoupler modules are turned on. Touch one end of a jumper wire to the 24 volt positive and the other end to pins D7 to D11, and ensure that the indicators, buzzer, and contactor are turned on. Now we are ready for the control logic. The control logic from the previous video has been modified to include the overload relay and the auxiliary contact of the contactor. Overload relay contacts are added in series with the start contact and in parallel with the stop contact as normally closed and normally open contacts respectively. The contactor auxiliary contact replaced the motor coil contact at this point for motor running indication. An additional room has the overload relay to indicate the trip and triggers the fault alarm. The last room resets the fault alarm. Pressing the start button will energize the contactor, which then gives the motor running feedback on the green indicator through the auxiliary contact. Same as for the stop button. While the motor is running, holding down the red button on the overload relay simulates the motor trip. You can see that the yellow indicator and the buzzer indicator are turned on. The yellow button resets the buzzer indicator, but an actual trip will keep the yellow indicator on, and the motor cannot be restarted until the fault is resolved. And that is it for now. An LCD can be added to show the operation of the PLC. Until then, don't forget to click on the like button. Share your thoughts in the comment section and consider subscribing if you have not. Thanks for watching.